So if you want to install macOS Ventura on your AMD systems with dual boot Windows 11 and macOS Ventura, this video is for you. So without getting much more delay, let's get started. So first of all, just open a browser and access the website olarila.com. Then just go to the vanilla images section. Here scroll a little bit and here you will find macOS Ventura downloading link. You will have to download the 13.6, that is latest. In your case it may be 13.7 or whatever, you can download from clicking here media file link. After downloading the vanilla image, you will have to download the EFI folder. Just click on the EFI folder section and scroll a little bit. On the desktop section, just scroll a little bit and here you will find AMD EFI. You can download this, and after that just search for Balena Etcher and open the very first link, Balena Etcher. Click on download Etcher and from here download the latest version by clicking here. After downloading, close the browser and open the download folder. In download folder you will find Balena Etcher, Olarila Ventura image and the EFI folder. I have created this EFI folder. If you want to create the EFI folder for your specific system, then you can follow this video. I have prepared a video how to create a EFI for AMD systems. Now just open the Balena Etcher and click on flash from files. Go to download folder, select the Olarila Ventura image and select open, and from here you can select your disk. I have inserted a 16 GB pen drive. Minimum 16 GB pen drive is required. Just click on flash, click on yes. Flashing has been started. You will have to wait here for 20 to 30 minutes to complete the whole process. Okay, when it is completed, it will show flash completed. Just close it. And if you find this type of user interface, just close it. Don't do anything. Now just open the file explorer. Now you will have to download another two application, that is mini partition tool wizard and file explorer plus plus. The downloading link of these two file will be given in the description. First of all, just extract the file explorer plus plus. Now just install the mini tool partition. Click on yes and accept all the terms and conditions, then just install it. It is installed. Just click on finish and it will launch automatically. It is launched. Just click on launch the application. Now just scroll a little bit and here you will find your pen drive. Just select the EFI folder and right click on it. Select change later. Then click on OK. Then click on apply. Then click on yes. Okay, it is done. Just close it and again go to the file manager and open the file explorer plus plus folder. Just select the explorer plus plus and right click on it. Run as administrator. Click on yes. Now from here go to download folder and copy the EFI folder. Just go back and open the EFI drive. Just paste it to here. Now just click on replace the file destination. Okay, it is done. Now you can close this and just now right click on the start menu and select disk management. From here you will have to create a minimum 128 GB drive to install macOS. From a bigger drive, just right click on it and click on shrink volume. I'm just taking 128 GB space and then just click on shrink. Now just right click on the unallocated space and select a new simple volume. Next. Put the name of the drive as macOS. Then click on next, then click on finish. Now macOS drive is created. Now just restart your PC and access the boot menu of your PC. To access the boot menu, you can refer this photo, otherwise you can search on Google. From the boot menu, just select your pen drive and hit enter. From this screen, just select the install macOS Ventura and hit enter. Now on the screen, just select your language and click on this icon. Select disk utility and click on continue. Now from the drop down, select show all devices. Now just select the macOS drive and click on erase. Select the APFS and click on erase. First time it will not erase, just click on done. Again select the macOS drive and click on erase. Again select APFS, then click on erase. This time it will be erased. Okay, it is done. Just close it and close the utility. Now just select install macOS Ventura. Now just click on continue, click on agree, then click on again agree. Now just select your macOS drive which you have created. Just click on continue. It will take 30 to 40 minutes to install. You'll have to wait here. Select your region and click on continue. Again click on continue. Click not now. Click on continue. Click on not now.
click on setup later, click on skip, click on agree, again click on agree. Here put your full name, then account name will be automatically populated. Then select your password, again verify the password, and you can put a hint, then just click on continue. Again click on continue, click on don't use, choose your city, then click on continue and check this, click on continue, click on setup later. Now just select the theme and click on continue. Okay, now just click on quite. Okay, macOS Ventura is installed on your PC. Now just open Safari browser. Okay, now here your browser will not work properly. Just search download Chrome, and from here just download the Chrome. After downloading, just go to here and open the DMG file, double tap on here, just drag and drop the Chrome to this folder, and it is installing. Just wait a few it. Okay, now just close it. Now just go to app drawer and open the Chrome browser. Now here just search for open core configurator. Now just select the very first link and just scroll a little bit, just download from here. The download has been started, you will have to wait here for a little bit. Download is completed, just minimize the browser. Now just open the Finder app and go to downloads. Here you will find the open core configurator, just double tap on it, open core will be extracted. Now just double click on open core configurator. Here you will find an error message. Click on OK and click on the Apple logo and select the system settings and go to privacy and security. Scroll a little bit and here you will find open core configurator. Just click on open anywhere. Just put the password and click on enter. Okay, just click on open. Now you can close the settings. Now just click on tools and click on mount EFI, and here you will find no name OS. Just click on mount partition and again put the password and hit enter. Just click on open partition. Now we can just minimize these, also minimize this. Now open the pen drive, open the EFI folder and select boot and OC, right click on it and select copy. Now on this folder, just open the EFI folder and right click, select paste to items. Now just click on replace. Okay, it is completed. Now everything is set up, just close everything and now just again click on start and restart your PC. Click on restart and now you can remove your USB pen drive before start. So friends, first of all just click on start bar and search for cmd and run as administrator. Click on yes, type bcdedit and hit enter. Now just type this command, command will be given in the description also, and hit enter. The operation is completed successfully. Now just close the command prompt. Now just simply restart your PC. Now just put the password of your macOS and hit enter. Now it is done.